Welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart, and in this video
we're gonna take the computer parts out of this Chief Tech case and gonna put it in this Sunflower case. You might wanna ask now, why should you do that? It's a great case. Yes, it is a great case, the Chief Tech, but my other two builds are already in silver aluminium cases and I want to make a matching set. And this is basically a basic version of the Ultimate Year 2000 build, but this one has a Furu 4 4500. The nice thing about the Sunflower case is that it is brand new and this is the factory plastic, so let's open it. If you want to know more about this case, please check out the link in the description because I made a video about them. And I have more than one of them. I actually own 10 of them. Here we have a Tweakers.net case badge, and that is from the Dutch Tech website. And I also have the DPC case badge from the Dutch Power Couch. This is really nostalgic. The system is really, really dirty. But it is running since 2013, so it needs a really good clean. First I'm gonna take my air compressor and clean the system. Then I will take it apart, then I will show the parts, and then we're gonna build it in the new chassis. I think this 12 cm fan was not a good idea, because there's so much dust here. But before I'm gonna clean it, I will take out the Furu 4. We have a Soundblaster Live, the CT4830. We have a 3DFX Furu 4 4500. And it's an HDP 4 time slot with 32 megabytes of memory. We have a 100 Mbit Intel network card. We have a 40 gigabyte single platter Maxtor IDE hard drive running at 7200 RPM. And this is really one of the fastest IDE hard drives. The motherboard is the Asus CUS-L2C with an Intel 815 chipset and 2 sticks of Kingston memory for a total of 512 megabyte SD RAM. And here we have a very nice terminal tay cooler with a Pentium 3 1 GHz. We need a power supply, and I'm gonna install this 235 watt power supply, and that's more than enough with this configuration. We're gonna install this white floppy drive. I have a 16 speed DVD player and a nice 12 speed Plexor writer. So let's see what games are on this system.
We have Diablo 2, R2 Racer 2, R2 Racer 3, The Sims 2, Age of Empires 2, Asteroid, Baldur's Gate, Blood Trader Chosen, Carmageddon 2, Counter-Strike, Decent Free Space, Dead Cars, Doom,
FIFA 99, that must be deleted. We don't want FIFA on the computer.
Half-Life, Heretic 2, Rage, Insane, Lego Loco, Populous 3, Quake 2, Railroad Tycoon 2, Rattler 2, Rutless, Serious Sam, Settlers, Sin, Test Drive, Dungeon Keeper, Rayman 2, Power Slide, Diablo, AT Racer, Pinball, Euros Defense, and of course Unreal Tournament.
Let's see, will Diablo 1 start or do we need to have the CD? I think I already played this game for 10 seconds on this system.
Awesome. Nice.
So here you have it, the little brother of the Ultimate Year 2000 gaming build. And it's also running the Pentium 3 1 GHz with 512 MB of memory and a 3DFX Voodoo 4 32 MB. The main reason to swap the cases is that the other two Ultimate Year 2000 gaming builds are already in silver aluminium cases, and I really love the premium look of an aluminium case like this. And this case is really great, but was not fitting in the whole setup for me. So that's why I choose for this case. But I will keep this case, so I don't gonna throw it away. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can check out Retro Machines on Facebook and support me on Patreon.